2, 1. Okay, here we are. We're talking about our tower boom installation. We're here at the Putter's Edge, and we're helping on an installation with a Mastercraft X25. It's a unique installation. We've already removed the panels out of our way on this tower, and we've identified them. Call the manufacturer. That's what you do by calling us toll-free. If you ever run into a problem, we will help you. Call us toll-free, 877-685-6270. I'll put it on the screen. From Australia, call us at 011-1863-207-2014. We're going to help you get you directly to the manufacturer, make sure it's right. We've identified on this tower, and here's what we've got. This is our tower boom clamp. This is the main clamp that takes the bolt of the weight. We've identified that it's going to go right here, would give us a little bit of clearance, and so that's where we're going to install this. This does not require any spacers on it because it fits perfectly right there. Now next, we've got our boom clamps are going to mount. We've got two of them, and we've identified that this is a little loose. So what we did is we used the supplied spacers, and you don't automatically need them. You only need these on the clamps that mount to the tower. And on this unique tower installation, there's two pieces of tubing. This is 2.5 inch. And so we're mounting one in the front, one in the rear. You notice on that boom clamp, we're moving it in the rear. On a different tower, it'd be different. That's why we're gonna help you make sure you get the right tower boom, the right boom to your boat, and then we'll help you with installation. If you had a Mastercraft that had no tubular section here, but it had a tubular leg to the front, all three clamps, the boom clamp and the tower boom clamps that go up high, all can mount on the front leg. But in this installation, we've identified that this clamp is too loose, so the supplied bushing that we have right here, we found out that it fits, so we are going to mount these right here, and we're just going to use the supplied tools that came with it, and the screws that go in, and we're going to mount one here and one here, and we'll be back when we have that done, and we'll talk about there's two other of these clamps that actually mount onto the first section of the tower boom that comes, that attaches to the boom clamp. We'll see you right back. Is that clear enough? All right, here we go. Now we're talking about putting on the rear, we're talking about putting on the boom clamp, which on this installation is gonna go on the rear leg. Now my buddy Keith wants this video here so you can see how silly I look when I'm doing it, but that's okay. We wanna show you how to get it done, and here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna mount this right here, and because we might later put this lower, I don't want it too close to this, so we can't move the boom down if we have to. We're gonna mount it right here. And here are the supplied bolts that are coming with it. And here's what we're gonna do, is we are gonna put it right about here, and we're gonna mount them loose. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put these kind of set right here. I'm gonna mount that through there. You see the writing on it. And then I'm gonna start to screw this in, see if I can do it without dropping. I'm just hand tightening basically right now. And what I want you to do is, on all these, I want you to kind of get it installed, but not too tight. I just want you to get this thing installed well enough so that you can make some adjustments, because it may be a little bit off, and so we might have to make some adjustments as we go. Okay, here's what I've done. I've taken the supply tool, I've got this loose. It's not real tight, it could actually fall. I'm gonna loosen up this back one just so I get the spacer right on it. But I don't want it so tight that it's gripping real hard, but I do want it tight enough so that it doesn't fall. And what we're gonna do on a tower boom installation, we never run it straight out the side. We always have a little bit angled forward and usually a little bit up. So here we go, that is the boom clamp is just tight enough to hold it right there, and I'm going to move on to the other one. Our clamps here that are going to go on the upper legs, as I mentioned, we've identified the correct spacer, which is supplied. Any questions, call us. So here we go. We've identified that we want to mount these right about here. see me sweating here a little bit, but the good news is I don't even own tools. So I'm not a tool guy. I don't own any tools. I got a little bag that pretty much looks like my wife put on it and knows a tool. So the nice thing is anybody can install this if you're patient. And if you call us, because we're going to help you do it. All right, so all I'm doing here is just tightening it enough to hold, then I got to chase my other bolts over. All right, so here we go. We've got our boom clamp mounted here. It's angled slightly forward because we're going to need to make some adjustments. We've got our top tower clamp here, our front top tower clamp here. We could have mounted it above here. We decided because it's a big boat, we want them lower in case we want to put the boom lower. But we're not tightening up anything because we got to make sure we got some room for adjustments. So when I get back to you, the next thing we're going to go over is putting on these similar clamps on the front section of the boom. Be right back.